Two key trade relationships will be in the spotlight as Prime Minister Trudeau forms his next government. First, there's the new NAFTA deal with the U.S. and Mexico. It still needs to be passed in Washington. Ottawa is also navigating a tumultuous relationship with Beijing. Today, China lifted its restrictions on Canadian beef and pork. Our Mike LeCouture joins us from Ottawa. Mike, how big of a hit did Canada take on that ban?
Well, Robin, this has been a $300 to $500 million headache for the Canadian meat industry. That's how much they estimate was lost in the last few months as a result of this trade dispute. China had banned the import of Canadian beef and pork when customs inspectors said they'd found traces of a banned animal feed additive in a shipment of pork claiming to be from Canada. But Canadian officials said those export permits were fake. The two countries have been in the middle of a diplomatic dispute ever since Huawei executive Meng Wanzhou was arrested in Vancouver last December. Government officials point out the meat ban was a very separate issue from the ban on canola exports and the two detained Canadians. Still, Canadian industry representatives say our new ambassador to China, Dominic Barton, was key to getting this ban lifted.
Having a point person in Beijing for the Canadian government to go in and to behave and have high-level conversations and point to the work that industry has done, to point to the work that CFIA has done, I think it just made it a lot easier for Chinese officials to feel comfortable with where Canadian industry and government were on the file.
Mike, what about the trade front south of the border and passing NAFTA 2.0?
Yeah, Robin, tomorrow the leader of the powerful U.S. House Ways and Means Committee, Democrat Richard Neal, will be in Ottawa to have a meeting with Chrystia Freeland. It's being billed as a check-in on how ratification is going of CUSMCA or that new NAFTA. And to give you an idea of how important this is, the Prime Minister is taking time to meet with those U.S. representatives. Now, the Americans also visited Mexico last month because they're worried that Mexico might not be able to enforce some of the labor rules in the New Deal. Global News has learned our Labor Minister, Patty Hajdu, will be part of tomorrow's meeting because she has also been doing some of the work on this file. Now, one government source made sure to point out, while Canada is open to side letters or small tweaks on the new NAFTA, Canada is not willing to renegotiate. And none of that is happening tomorrow. Robin.
Mike LeCouture in Ottawa. Thanks, Mike.